स्पीकिंग ऑफ प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन अप टू 2010, हमने देखा कि जो प्रीलिम्स एग्जाम था इट वाज मोर अबाउट, ज़्यादा फैक्ट्स पूछते थे, ठीक है, बट नाउ इट हैज़ शिफ्टेड टू मोर कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी और बेसिक्स पे ध्यान दे रहे हैं ज़्यादा. एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज़ दैट यूपीएससी इज़ नॉट ऑन अ सिंगल ट्रेंड, इट्स चेंजिंग. So the most important thing what we should do is that, or students should do is that, they should diversify their way of studying through different sources, so that they does not stick to a single trend. So they keep on changing. So it will become more helpful for them. मुझे लगता है कि कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी करने की ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है प्रीलिम्स में, जिसमें करंट अफेयर और बेसिक टेक्स्ट बुक्स और एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक पर्टिकुलरली, वी नीड टू हैव अ मोर क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच आर मेंशन्ड इन द एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक्स, बी इट हिस्ट्री, पॉलिटी, ज्योग्राफी और एनी अदर सब्जेक्ट लाइक इकोलॉजी एंड एनवायरमेंट. एंड ऑन द अदर पार्ट, न्यूज़ पेपर हैज़ टेकन अ स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस फॉर प्रीलिम्स एज वेल एज मेंस एग्जामिनेशन. And one should continue reading newspaper and consolidating what is happening around different areas.
So does coaching help in IAS prelims exam?
Well, like it's a sort of bland question, but I will say that it's up to you. Like if you have kick-started it before in graduations and you have already आपने पूरी तैयारी करके रखी है, अपने कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी पूरा है, तो मुझे नहीं लगता कि किसी चीज़ की कोचिंग की ज़रूरत है. लेकिन हाँ, कुछ लोगों को इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम टू प्रिपेयर किसी तरीके से. डेफिनेटली अगर उनको, इफ़ दे आर फाइनेंशियली ओके विद, कोई हार्म नहीं है कोचिंग करने में इसमें, उससे इट विल एक्ट एज अ ग्रीज टू द व्हील. अदरवाइज व्हील तो चलेगा ही, लेकिन थोड़ा सा ठीक से, थोड़ा सा जल्दी होके आसानी हो जाएगी उनको. बट डेफिनेटली मैं आई विल रिट्रीट द अगेन द सेम थिंग, कोई एडवांटेज नहीं मिलेगा ऐसा कुछ, बस ये है कि उनको ज़्यादा आसानी होगी तैयारी करने में.
सर, जो लोग वर्किंग होते हैं उनके स्पेसिफिकली,
मुझे लगता है कि वर्किंग वाले हैं तो कोचिंग कर ही नहीं पाएंगे. तो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू बैलेंस टू थिंग्स, एंड पर्टिकुलरली नाउ द सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रोफेशनलिज्म विच हैज़ कम इन प्रिपरेशन इन द सिविल सर्विस एग्जामिनेशन, इट हैज़ बिकम मोर टफ. So it's always better to, whenever somebody is planning to give this examination, there should be a complete dedication and focus of almost 8 months before the examination. And those people who are working, they should continuously do exercise 2 to 3 hours a day, or 2 hours minimum at least. Go for the newspapers, clear the concepts regarding textbooks and the syllabus of mains, complete the notes or synopsis of optional subject. When they are ready for the examination, they can take a short leave of like 5 months or 2 months before prelims and 3 months after before mains. So I think it's a perfect mix of how you manage it. Definitely they can do it, but a proper plan and a very strict timetable is required for people, particularly who are in services.
So how important is current affairs in IAS prelims exam?
Soul of the prelims, actually. There is a balance between the basics as well as the current affair, but there is a connection between the two in such a way that current affair is linked to the basics. Okay, like if there is basic concept of CAG, like under Article 148 of Polity, maybe this was in news. There was some controversy going around CAG, thus it becomes in news. So the basic concepts are connected with the current affair. Thus, whatever is happening in the current affair, one should know the nitty-gritties of that issue as well as जो उसके साथ basic हैं टेक्स्ट बुक्स में हैं उसको भी पढ़ने की ज़रूरत है.
So what was your strategy for IAS prelims exam as a whole?
I think one should not divide the strategy of prelims and mains in a very binary logic, binary way. But there should be an integrated preparation for prelims and mains. Again, which is starts with textbooks and some standard textbooks and reference books. But one has to make sure that before prelims, two and a half months before prelims, one should have an approach towards prelims, like they can solve more mock test series and do a lot of mocks and identify the problems and narrow points which are in the textbooks and standard reference books, which can help them to minimize the negatives and they become confident to appear for the civil service examination.
How did you balance the different sections as in IAS prelims exam, especially nowadays geography and environment section is gaining popularity?
I will say that I will not talk it is a particular section is a bullish or bearish figure, but I will say that the beauty of the civil service examination is one should focus on each and every area, because a single unit or a single paper will not fetch you a top rank in civil service examination. One has to do equity, and equity is that each and every section has to be dealt. We have to do justice with each and every section, and that builds on the confidence actually. So I think rather than specifically focusing on certain units, one should do a very wholesale approach and cover all the sectors and sections properly and with full preparation.
Sir, you were unable to qualify in the first three attempts of IAS prelims. What you would have done differently?
I think I did not understand one thing, that was that this examination has three phases: prelims, mains and interview. And I was unnecessarily focusing on mains examination. I thought that my strength is about writing this examination, my writing skills are good. But in the garb of that strength, I could not gauge my weakness. That was paper second of CSAT. So unfortunately, I could not focus on prelims, so I was not qualifying it. So it was my mistake. So the takeaway point from this is that one should focus on its weakness and should strengthen them in such a way that you do a purposeful study and work hard to clear this examination from each and every step. Because unless and until you not qualify the prelims examination, it's not possible to showcase your skills in the mains. So each and every part of the examination is important, and we should do justice with each and every part of it.
Sir, as you talked about CSAT,
what was your strategy for CSAT? Well, now it is qualifying, but still one should go for half an hour or 45 minutes of practice daily. And maybe the books, there are many books in the market, like R. Sagarwal is a very good book, both on reasoning as well as in quantitative aptitude. So though people who have some issues with the CSAT, they should do a daily practice of about half an hour to 45 minutes and solve comprehension and read, do a lot of reading. I think with the sheer hard work and practice, one can conquer the so-called toughness of the paper second.
What advice would you like to give for the future candidates?
I think one should have a strong belief that one can do it. And with that positivity in the mind, one can crack this examination. But remember, I would want to say to the future candidates that take it as an examination. Don't make it as an obsession or an ego. Life is beautiful, and it can be. And if somebody does not qualify this examination in three or four attempts, or one exhausts all the attempts, the whole world is there to accept him. In different fields, they can shine. Not qualifying civil examination does not mean one is not does not have talent to work. Maybe he's made for some different world, and I think it's a positive sign. The hard work and the level of effort one has done, definitely it pays off, maybe in a different form, in a different sector.